the Ruger LC Carbine in 45 ACP. Let's check it out. Released their PC9 carbine. It stands for pistol caliber carbine. It actually was a revival of an older version that they had done many years ago, and it's been extremely popular. There's a lot of mods you can do to it. They've got the charger, which is a pistol form. It takes Glock mags, or it takes the standard Ruger mags. And so it just gives you a lot of options. Then they came out with their LC carbine, which means light compact, N57. And it was more of a metal construction. The magazine went into the grip, and great little carbine. And it was good to see 5.7 and another option. And now they've come out with their LC carbine in 45 ACP. This is a light and handy carbine. It's about the size of the 5.7 by 28, but yet it has that 45 punch to it. Guys, this takes Glock mags just straight up, and it goes through the grip. So you don't have another mag well that's hanging off. It's got a ton of different features. When it says compact, has a folding stock. We're gonna take a good look. Ruger has really stepped it up with a lot of firearms that are very up to date, very modular. There's a lot you can do with this. And again, it comes in that hard hitting 45 ACP. And while we really appreciate Ruger for sending the LCP carbine, we're gonna give you an honest review, like we always do. We have the LC Carbine 5.7 on the top, and this was the original, and now with the 45 ACP. Now, you may ask, why not 9mm? But they did make the PC Carbine, or the PC9, now, which really is a completely different configuration. One of the things about the LC9 is it has a magwell in front of the trigger guard, and honestly, it's more set up like a 10-22, and the takedown 22, because it does come apart. And it's a little bit cheaper. We'll talk about the pricing in a minute. But there's a lot of things you can do with the PC9 carbine, especially in the charger form. But here we have a lot more metal with either one of these rifles. And honestly, they're exactly the same length. But really, the receiver on the 45 is a little bit longer, but it has a little bit of a shorter handguard. And guys, 45 ACP is a heavy, slow-moving bullet. This is 230 grains, a full metal jacket, compared to 62 grains, but going a heck of a lot faster. Velocity on the 5.7 by 28 can get up to 2,800 feet per second. And with the 45 ACP, we're talking about 860 feet per second. But again, it is a much heavier bullet. So these are really two completely different rounds, but yet can both be used for self-defense. They want to drop our magazine. They use Glock pattern 45 magazines, and these are the full size. And these are 13-round magazines. Now, this is the SGW magazine, which honestly, out of all the aftermarket mags for Glock, the SGW seem to work the best. And then, of course, you can use your standard Glock mags as well. And let's make sure the gun's unloaded. Now, the overall length of the LC carbine in 45 is 28.5 inches. If you extend the stock, it's 30.5. It does have a folding stock, which we'll check out, and it breaks it down to 22 inches in total length. Now, on the folding stock, there is a button right here, and you just press it, and it folds it down. It gets it to the other side, and then it has a little bit of a detent that holds it, but there's no locking. But it does take just a little bit, and to be honest, this thing is not going to come loose. And then just bring it out, lock it into place. Again, it is adjustable, and so we can bring this out. And then, of course, we have a cheek piece on top. And in the cheek piece, there's a small little area right here. You can lift it up, and you can adjust this stock back. And actually, I believe you can bring this off. But if you want to lock it down, you just move it forward, bring up that little lever, and you lock it in. And this does give you a good cheek weld for your optic. Rubberized butt pad. We also have QD ports. And this is mounted by Picatinny rail. So if you want to put a standard AR-15 buffer tube on here that adapts to a Picatinny rail, you can. The receiver is very well machined. Honestly, to the point that it looks like black nitride, but it is an anodized finish. It's type 3 hard anodizing. Nice relief cuts here and here. Of course, the bolt is nitrided. It does come in a two-piece bolt. We'll look at that when we break it down. And here on the other side, we have our charging handle. Now, this can also be switched to the other side. So you do have that side charging handle capability to be able to load your rounds. And it's very smooth in the action. But here you can see the plate, and this just goes from one side to the other. Now we have a safety right here, and according to Ruger, it says it's a 1911 style safety, and that just means that when you bring it down, it is ready to fire. A very straight grip angle, and you know, it's a lot like your 1911 or your 45 grip angle. Nice checkering all the way through, and we do have somewhat of a mag well that allows those mags to go in and out. Here at the front of the grip, we just have a patch of texturing. The grip fits really good into your hand. It does have that slight mag well, so it does kind of push it up just a little bit. Right here, you'll notice that we have a bolt stop. But the bolt stop on the other side is larger, and it's more of a paddle, and so it's a little bit more extended. And then here is your safety. So it does have ambidextrous safeties, ambidextrous bolt stops. Now, your magazine release is right here. You can switch it to the other side. And so if you're using the Glock mags that have two catches on either side, you can switch it over. If you only have mags that have the cut on one side, you'll have to leave it on the right side of the rifle. So if you're left-handed, you want to go with these two-notch mags. There's relief cuts right here and here, and they're not on the other side. And of course, that just allows you to see a little bit more of your bolt. Right here we have our takedown pin, and we'll take a look at that. And this area is enlarged. The other area is much smaller, so it goes out from this side. Nice Picatinny rail right in front of the trigger guard. And then it has this little ramp right here. I think maybe you could put an angled forearm here, but to me, it's just an unusual place to put a Picatinny rail. And then we have some texturing right here at the front of the trigger guard. Ample trigger guard, great for gloved hands. It has the secure action little blade safety for your trigger. So if it hits anywhere but it does not depress your trigger, it's not going to fire. There's an internal trigger safety. There's also a lightweight firing pin. That keeps the firing pin from moving forward. It's a neutrally balanced sear, and also the hammer catch actually keeps the hammer from hitting the firing pin. Plus you have your manual frame safety right here. We have M-lock slots all the way around the handguard. And on the 5.7, it only had M-lock slots at the 3, 6, and 9 o'clock. So this just gives you a little bit of an advantage for extra points for M-lock. It has a 5.78x25 thread pitch, which is good for .45 caliber. And that way you can put muzzle brakes, compensators, or suppressors. And it does have a silicone washer in there to keep this in place, so it's not going to walk off. Now we have the Ruger rapid deployment sights, and these are just M-bus sights. They fold down. There's a little button on the side that deploys them, and we also have a rear sight. But this is excellent for optics. There's a lot of real estate for this Picatinny rail. But the receiver is CNC machined, and you can tell it's very finely finished. I mean, it really has a great look to it, and it's one of the things I really like about the LC Carbine over even the PC9. The PC9 has a lot of the polymer, but again, you can change those out to more tactical type configurations. One thing also about your PC9 is you have your charger availability. So, you know, you can go with a much smaller package. Now, the LC Carbine in 45 is plus P rated. So you can shoot your standard self-defense loads in here, but it'll also function with your target loads and your full metal jacket. With the PC9, you have the availability to use your SR9 mags or your Security 9 mags. And you can change that magazine well out, and then you can put in Glock mags. But honestly, I mean, people are using Glock mags pretty much predominantly in all the different firearms. So it's great to have that availability to have your standard Glock mags. Plus, you can use your higher capacity mags as well. Now, with this kind of Picatinny rail, we can put a lot of different scopes on here. We're just going to be shooting the Trigicon MRO. And really, it gets a good cheek weld, and it actually co-witnesses with the sights. Now let's check the trigger pull action. Again, with that blade safety, it's not going to engage the trigger. So you have to have a full pad on that little lever. And as we bring it back, got a little bit of take up. And guys, it's not much. A little bit of resistance, And then a really nice break, and it's crisp. Let's look at reset. Right there. That's a really nice trigger. Test the trigger pull weight with our Lyman trigger gauge. 5 pounds, 8 ounces. 5 pounds, 8.5 ounces. Let's check the weight on the LC Carbine in 45 auto. 7 pounds, 1.4 ounces. I want to give a big thank you to Fiocchi for sponsoring our ammo. All made in the USA, one of the largest suppliers of ammunition in the country. And I forgot my Lula loader, and I could definitely use it, but these Glock mags aren't too bad. Now again, we're using standard Glock mags, but we're also using the SGM mags. And guys, I'm telling you, I mean, I've had a lot of experience with these, and they just tend to work. LC Carbine, 45 ACP. We're using the 13 round Glock mags and the SGM mags as well. Nice mag well, makes it really easy to insert. It goes right in your grip. You know, the fit and finish of this rifle is excellent. There's a lot of options. We're not really utilizing most of them with the M-Lock accessories. Of course, we have our side charging handle. It's really nice, and again, you can switch that. I mean, this folding stock, of course, the safety is that 1911 style safety, which is very natural. Like the grip angle, the trigger is really nice. You can feel the mass bolt going back, but the recoil is nice. It's right in the center. The recoil kind of goes in the center, but it's not a lot of recoil on your shoulder. It's more just in this area. You can put suppressors on here pretty easily. It's just a great little rifle. And when the 5.7 came out, I mean, I love it. And honestly, I was surprised they came out with the 45 first, but love 45. And I've got my PC9. As they say, they all fall to ball. We haven't had one malfunction whatsoever. Not any kind of hiccup or anything. I mean, this thing is just running. But again, it makes it super compact, easy to stow away, easy to deploy, and again, Glock mags. All right, for disassembly, let's go ahead and drop our magazine. We're gonna make sure the gun is unloaded, and it is. Now right here is your takedown pin. So we're just gonna bring a block in, and I'm gonna take a punch, and we're just gonna push this through. And it comes right through. Now it is retained in the back. One of the things about the 5.7 is the pin would come right out, and you could use either side. Also, the pin was closer up to the front. So now we're gonna take our receiver and just pull it down. So what I did was is just pulled it down and back and it comes right off. This is what's considered the firearm. There are some steel plates right in here and here. We have steel plates up at the front and here at the back. And then we have, of course, our action. This is an internal hammer fired pistol. So you do have your hammer right here. And then of course you see your controls. But a really cool, very modular type system. Now this does have the heavy mass bolt system. So we're gonna pull back, it's a two-piece bolt system. And once it gets to a certain point, we can just pull out the bolt. I mean, that is pretty impressive just in itself. Next, we're gonna release our charging handle. And then you wanna take and get this little spring out. You wanna kinda go forward. We can get back here behind this buffer and we can push it and lift it up. And so you can see your buffer and that's the best way. And then we can just pull out our recoil spring. This is going to just give you some cushioning with that rubber buffer. Next, just go ahead and bring back your charging handle again, and that's going to allow for the second part of your bolt to come back. And once you get it to the rear, it'll pull out. It won't come out unless it's toward this back. I mean, guys, this thing is impressive. It is very large and beefy. And so that's going to really translate to recoil at the range. And guys, we haven't shot this yet, as you can tell, so we're going to find out when we get out there. And guys, that's all you need to do to field strip. And of course, you can take this plate and change it to the other side. We're not going to do that, but you know, it's a fairly simple process, and you can look at your owner's manual. Now for reassembly, we're going to put that first part of our bolt, again, drop it in and just go forward with it. Next, we're going to put in our recoil spring and our guide rod back in, kind of go forward and then push down. You'll hear it click into the track. Now you want to bring your bolt back and into the farthest position, and that's going to allow you to drop in the second part of your bolt. And so then we just release it slowly, and then we're back in business. Now there are some wings right here and a couple at the back. Corresponds with the wings in your upper receiver here and toward the back. So what we're going to do is line up those notches and put them into place, and it should drop down into it. It's like that. And then just move it forward. And once we have those into place, just take your takedown pin and just drop it. Now, we're going to go ahead and check to make sure the gun is functioning. And it's back in business. Now, it does come with an M-Lock QD port. It also comes with a front sight adjustment tool. And we have a couple of hex wrenches. And you get your lock. I kind of like this one because it's really compact. But guys, there's so many different pistol caliber carbines out there on the market. And obviously, there's a lot of AR-15 options as well. But with Ruger, I mean, you get a whole different setup. You get a side charging handle. You get that really heavy mass bolt. Just gives you a lot of options. And the great thing is, you can go with 45 ACP, or you can go with 5.7 by 28. But with the popularity of these, I'm sure we'll probably see 9mm coming in. But the PC9 carbine is also an excellent choice. It's different, and it costs a little less. But honestly, in some ways, it's even more versatile. Now, the MSRP on the LC carbine in 45 ACP, or 45 Auto, is $1,009. And that's retail price. Typically, you go into your gun shop, and you can pick it up for less. Now, the PC9 carbine, coming out with its standard configuration, is just $779. Full retail. So it does give you a lesser price option, but there's something about the full aluminum construction that just gives this a lot of strength, and there's just something really pleasing about it. Now, definitely with the grip module, you know, it is going to be polymer, but that really fits well in your hand. As far as pros and cons, very lightweight, handy carbine. Going with 45 ACP, you've got your Glock mags, which makes it really affordable for your magazines, and they're pretty plentiful. Nice collapsible stock, that really gets this package down to a very small size. Of course, side charging handle, and you can switch that. Plenty of room for scopes, M-Lock accessories. Of course, it is a threaded barrel. Honestly, with all the success of the 5.7 carbine, it's really hard to pick out a lot of negatives. I think the one thing is it's just going to cost you about $300 more than your PC9 carbine. But to me, you're getting more bang for your buck, and it does come with the M-Bus sights. So to me, an excellent choice for home defense, for a car gun. It's very compact, very packable. And with 45 ACP, it makes an excellent self-defense round. And guys, to be honest, it's really nice to see some more 45 ACP options out on the market. And with the 5.7, that's a big plus for these two carbines. So the LC carbine in 45 ACP, it gives you that 45 hard-hitting round, great for self-defense, great for out to the range, great for home defense. And gives you just so many options. And it's one of the things, again, that Ruger has been doing, is just putting out some really innovative firearms. And again, a big thanks to Ruger for sending the LC carbine in 45 ACP. Be strong, be of good courage. God bless America. Long live the Republic. There are some relief cuts into the receiver on either side. Oh no. There are more M-lock slots than it was than there were. There's more M-lock.
And while we really appreciate
for these two handguns. I mean. All right. I want to give a big thank you to